What's a soulmate?
It's like a best friend, but more. It's the one person in the world who knows you better than anyone else. It's someone who makes you a better person. Actually, they don't make you a better person, you do that yourself. Because they inspire you. A soulmate is someone who you carry with you forever. It's the one person who knew you and accepted you and believed in you before anyone else did, or when no one else would. And no matter what happens, you'll always love them. Nothing can ever change that.
Him and I clicked right off the bat when I met him April 20th of 1993. Nick comes running up to me and he's like, "Hey man, what's your name?" Yeah. Actually, it's like, "Hey man, what's your name?"
When I was 14.
13.
I was 13. My parents had signed over guardianship to him. So he was actually raising me on the road at like 13, 14 years old.
I mean, he still pisses on toilets and things like that. Yeah, but I'm just saying, he's a grown-ass man.
Right.
No, he's a good dude. Like I said, he was my little brother. And like, when you talk about a dynamic relationship, we always had like the dynamic relationship. I'm gonna love you
the best that I can. I look at him more of being the spirit.
He has been the one person who, when times have gotten tough, he'll never quit. He'll never say never.
But that's why we love him, because Brian is adorable. Time cannot tear us apart. No, no, no. We're stronger than yesterday.
Yeah. And though we've traveled so far, you're still close to me. Love changes everything. And I know that it's alright.
When I became a Backstreet Boy, I took you, Nate, under my wing to nurture, to love, and to grow. You were like my little brother that I never had. I love you for everything that you love.
You know, I mean, we have a super dynamic relationship because we're Frick and Frack, and sometimes we're on great together, and sometimes we're doing it too.
Shut the fuck up and let me talk.
You shut the fuck up.
Listen, you said
you want to hear. Shut the fuck up.
You
shut the fuck up. I swear to God.
You want to hear everything.
Don't fucking talk to me that way.
I'll talk to you however I want to talk to you.
You don't get respect out of me that way.
Everybody around the table.
Don't be a fucking dick like everyone knows you are.
You don't.
You understand what I'm saying? Don't be a fucking dick.
Don't be a dick.
You don't want to hear. Trust me, you don't want it from me, baby. Trust me.
I'm
not afraid of you anymore.
Dude, what? Were you afraid of me?
Are we going to talk about the fact that you don't
necessarily sound as good as you used to? Are we
going to
talk about that? Are we going to talk about that? When producers come up to us and are saying, what's wrong with Brian's voice? What's happening with his voice? And then you want to sing on the records, dog, and you sound great on the records because you could do a fucking little bit of editing. But when we got to go on stage and sing that shit and we got to go do a world tour, I mean, this is all I'm trying to say.
You take the good and the bad, dog.
No, because
you take the good and the bad. We're a group.
Somehow it got blown up into an argument between you and Brian in a competition over lead vocals. And there's a lot of baggage here from the fucking past 20 years that is coming out now.
I mean, that happens, you know, in families and, you know, groups. But, you know, right after then, you know, we made up and we kind of saw eye to eye.
Hey, you know, I'm passionate, and the place that I was coming from in the film was a place from my heart. And it's, you know, we're brothers, you know, and I care about every single one of these guys. So at the end of the day, you know, I think that came across, so I'm not really.
He cares about me more than
basically. Yeah.
Just shows that he cares Brian's about Brian.
What is it, your hardest on the ones you love the most?
Yes. Yeah.
So he must love the heck out of you.
That's why Brian's his favorite. He really hates the rest of them.
I'm privileged.
We tend to see each other, you know, 200 days, 250 out of the year. You know what I mean? I don't know. It's like, so we don't have enough time to miss each other that much.
He turns all red and sweats and he's like,
I mean, it's
sexy.
I
didn't
give it
up. I see how you're shiny, but I have my makeup on.
I don't have any makeup on.
See, you're shiny. Your texture is like a shiny little powder.
And 20 mornings out of 22, I woke up and make an hour spooning. So.
My cohorts being dorks over there. See how they are? Kids.
That did not taste like my water.
Hey, I didn't do nothing.
This is different than
I
that.
Didn't do nothing. You just took my water and you just
put it.
Right.
She reminds me a lot of myself.
You know, he doesn't say much, right?
That's why Nick loves her so much. That's why Nick loves her so much.
Hey, Frick and Frack, I know how to use my wood here.